Touch me, you fall. Before I fall. Okay, that's the list from the Indigo Girls right here at WECS and live in the studio. Just a little bit early. We have for you Bloodshot. How you doing, guys?
Pretty good.
Well.
All right.
I am well.
All right, we'll talk like this. Can we hear? Yes, we can.
Yeah, we can be heard.
I'll turn up you guys a little bit.
Ah.
I'm going to take the
Whoa, you speak.
Okay, tell us a little bit about yourselves. How'd you guys get together?
Well, we had a band a long time ago called Music Box. And it started out with Dan, Jordan, and I, and another kid named Casey on guitar. And Casey was not well liked by Dan, so Dan quit. And then Casey wasn't well liked by Jordan, so Jordan quit. And then I just said, well,
there's no band.
So then we got back together and basically replaced the guitarist
with someone better.
With someone better.
Who was cool.
A hell of a lot better.
Hell yeah.
He rocks.
And then
thanks.
And now we're Bloodshot.
Now you guys were at a battle of the bands or something?
Yeah, in Windsor, Connecticut. And we had a pretty good show. It was our first practice together.
We had practiced like for 10 minutes in my basement, and then we decided to pack up and go to the battle of the bands.
And I had never met the guitarist before, or vice versa.
Yeah, it was the first day they met each other, and we had a kick butt show.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I wish I could have been there. That was at UConn?
No,
it was LP Wilson in Windsor.
Community Center in Windsor. We had about 7 bands there. A couple of good ones. One Society today. They couldn't be playing a
November's
show.
November's are better, though.
Oh, boy.
You're going to get beat up.
What made you guys decide to be musicians?
I can't do anything else.
Really?
No, seriously.
I'm not surprised.
Well, actually, I started because my uncle plays bass. And when I was about, 10 years old, he gave me a really old, cheesy bass of his, and I started playing that. And then I borrowed one of my friend's father's basses and played that for a couple of years, and I finally got my own.
And I've been stolen. So I've been,
yeah, and then it was stolen. Oh, so I got another bass. And it's along with my brand new Fender amp, which really made me mad. But then I got another bass and started this band.
Okay, Dave.
And that's how I've been playing
and
the bass.
I started off playing guitar, and then I've only been playing for a couple months on drums, but...
When I was 3 years old, my parents got me a violin. And then ever since then.
I played trumpet.
Hey. I played saxophone too. And I played piano, but that didn't work. And I tried guitar, but I can't play that either. And I can't play bass.
Myself.
I should have brought my harmonica down. I could have joined you guys.
The blues jam.
You guys have any goals?
Get out of Windsor?
Yeah.
We want to be Nirvana.
No.
I hear there's an opening.
Pretty big head from what I heard about, where his head used to be.
Did you guys just get together just to play for the hell of it at the start?
Well, we kinda wanted to start a serious type band, but we wanted to see how it went, so we played the Battle of the Bands, had a good show, and
I quit an old band called Jinx because I wanted to be more serious.
And now they're ripping off all his material.
Stole all his material.
But,
what can you do?
All of it.
Can you imagine yourself someday seeking a contract?
Yes.
Hopefully.
Yes.
There's nothing else we can do.
You gonna do a video?
We did one. It's really cool.
Really?
See, me and Jordan.
Lots of girls in leather.
All right. I'm the lead singer and Jordan the drummer.
Beat
Matt over the head with some bottles. And we have fake blood spraying out of his mouth just for this special guar-like effect.
So he did a cool dance, too.
He did a really cool dance. And we must
and it was to one of our songs.
Yes, it was.
Called Toy Convict.
I love that song.
Toy Convict.
We should send a copy and we'll play it on
You're
the
good singer.
ECSU channel, channel 16 or something.
We got another copy we can give you right here, actually.
No, he meant video.
Video?
Yeah.
On TV. Yeah.
We should work a little more on the video if we're going to send that.
Let me see. Oh, Mom. What do you think about other local groups in the area?
I think that most of them are kind of... They're
overrated.
They're really...
No.
The people are too old, and it's not very interesting, because they play the same way like Judas Priest, and they're like Firehouse or whatever.
There are a couple cool bands in Windsor, though. Actually, Windsor... I think Windsor's got a lot of good bands. A lot more than a lot of other towns.
I like MI6 because the drummer is nice to me.
I was just going
to
say, do you like MI6? I hate the drummer, though. He's a pansy.
And listen, who else is good? I like the Novembers because they're actually cool people and they're in Windsor and they're kind of Smashing Pumpkins esque and so I recommend them.
I think they're
really cool. I like.
There's also a good band. A lot of people don't like them because they got attitudes. But Society Today.
No, they're a good band.
They play well. They've got a
but like got a few screws.
These guys are all foreign.
They're all Image.
Yeah, basically.
Have you ever heard of the Village?
I've heard of them. Do they play like for old people?
Yeah, they play a lot of rock covers.
Yes.
But they're very good. They're very talented. They can write a lot of good stuff too. But different type of genre.
Yeah.
What do you prefer to write about in your music?
Dan,
Here.
I like
you
to write.
You do all the writing, Dan.
He wrote Losing Ground, and he wrote. Another one that we're about to do tonight. It's called Downbeat. It's sort of a fun bluesy song.
It's silly.
But other than that, like the lyrics that I write, they're basically, and sometimes we're just fooling around. Sometimes, I mean, there's really no, like the ones that like are on our demo are sort of just like aggressive. But
you wrote a lot of those before you informed, right?
Yeah. So it's sort of like, I don't know. There's no real style. I don't know what I'm doing.
It's like an itch in the brain.
What do your parents feel about this? They backing you?
Yeah,
well,
they're backing
to an extent, but they don't want us to lose track of school.
As long as I do my homework,
they
same here.
The profanity.
I was going to say, as long as you stay in school, that's
good.
Be cool.
I'm graduating this year, so hey.
I have to get that GPA up.
That's right.
I should graduate.
Anything above 2, right?
Yes.
Yeah, otherwise
I'm above 2. I'm not that stupid.
Are you going to be going to college? Or?
I am in college.
Are you kind?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's right, that's why you're always up there.
Yes.
That's why you're always at the disc. Do you do any covers?
Polly.
You're going to do a cover of Polly tonight.
You're going to do Polly tonight.
Polly.
Polly was a ganger. But,
Mother.
You said before that you like to rip off a lot of groups.
Well, no. I said that in passing as sort of like as a joke, but sort of because.
There's nothing else to say.
No, because our style sort of. Like, I don't know, lingers in what has already been done.
Hardcore with a funk twist.
Nothing wrong with that.
But it's got like a lot of bands don't have like a funk bass with hardcore guitar over it.
That's another thing I noticed. You guys got a lot of funky bass on there.
That's David.
Do you like Follow Flea or what?
Yeah, that was really? He was one of my influences.
Let's play.
And we like to play with that blend works, that blend of distortion and clean bass.
We bring a lot of different kind of music into our band.
And we don't like to have to sing. I don't like to have to sing the same way all the time. Like, because it gets boring.
Sometimes you don't want to be sitting there screaming all the time. You don't want to be singing like
Smashing Pumpkins all the time. It hurts.
Yes.
That's too bad.
I know.
It's kind of like swallowing a bunch of rusty nails, right?
Yeah, drinking bleach. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to go to a public service announcement right now. And then, it sounds different now. And then we're going to set these guys up and we're going to play a couple tunes for you. But right now, I got to read this public service announcement. Here's a tough question for you. You guys, too, can answer this. What do you do if someone you work with is using drugs?
Compliment them.
You tell them to get help.
Do you guys, can I ask you that? Do you guys use drugs?
I do not.
I have.
Only if it's prescribed.
I'm the lead singer. I do not, ever. Never. I'm serious.
That's
okay. I'm not
That's
kidding.
Good to hear. You guys prefer a natural high?
Yes.
Very good
high
to hear.
Light. I'm high on Jesus.
No, for real. I do not. I want everyone to know that I do not at all, ever.
No, we really don't do that.
Hey, uncross your legs there. I mean, your arms or your fingers, anyway. You can't ignore it because sooner or later, it's going to affect you and everyone else where you work. And more than likely, it's going to cost the drug user their job. You know, if... Oh, yes, it sucks. It adds up, the money. But as it said right here, anyone you work with, it will affect you all. Take for case in point, Sid Vicious.
Wow.
All right, you know what I mean? So I think you guys can relate to that. Do you tell your supervisor or your boss or your lead singer? Do you talk to the person involved and let them know you're in trouble, that you should seek help? Well, maybe you should. Maybe you should call for some help. And if you don't know what to do, call 1-800-662-HELP. They'll be connected with someone you can provide help with. The most important thing for you to do, though, is to do something.
I know where they can get some.
Help, right?
Yeah.
I think we all know where we can get some. Brought to you by The Drugs Don't Work and the Partnership for a Drug-Free America. We'll be back with Bloodshot. What's the name of the group? Yeah, Bloodshot, right after this.
Thanks, everybody, for coming to our safety belt therapy session. I'm Vince.
I'm Larry. We're crash dummies.
Hey, and believe me, we've been through it all.
Now, who'd like to start?
Oh, I will. Hi, my name's Bob.
Hi, Bob.
And I don't buckle up when I'm in the back seat.
Maybe some word association will help. Broken.
Legs.
Emergency.
Room.
Medical.
Bill.
Now you got the idea.
How about you, Jimmy?
Hi, Jimmy.
I don't want to be here. My mom made me come.
But don't you realize safety belts save lives?
Well, yeah, but I'll never get into an accident.
Hey, if you believe that, kid, you really are crazy.
Anyone else? Yes, Sally.
Hi, Sally.
I have this fear of being trapped in my car. That's why I don't wear my safety belt.
Well, take a look at these ink blots and tell me what you see.
A butterfly?
Good.
Two people kissing.
Hmm.
Ew, what's that?
You, if you're not buckled up.
Okay, folks, great work. See you next week.
Hey. Let's be careful out there.
This message brought to you by the Ad Council and the Department of Transportation.
Hi, this is Todd from the Toadies on Grass Records. You know, I really hate it when some nobody rock band comes on the radio and tells me what to do. But if you were to ask me about guns, I would say, even though we're from Texas, we urge you to practice gun safety. If you have to own a gun, keep your ammunition separate and keep your guns locked up.
This message was brought to you by Grass Records, So-and-So Promotions, and the National Association of College Broadcasters.
Yes, and we're back here. That was the Weather Boy toy. He wants to talk to me.
Weather Boy, we're busy right now.
And this is Bob
from Paul and Bob.
Shut up, Bob. Okay, thank you. Wrong song. Whoops. Close that.
Anyhow, we've got for you Bloodshot. What's the first song going to be?
Swallow. That's the first song on the tape I got. All right, let me turn you guys on.
All right, are you guys turned on by me yet?
I think so. I'm getting too loud.
That's you, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Testing and, one.
Let's test the guitars here.
Testing one, oh, two.
That's you too.
Hold on, Dan. Hold
test,
on.
Testing one, two, three. Testing. I'm too loud.
Yeah.
A little.
Alright. Play like a riff real quick. Okay.
Just test it. Sit down, children, don't misbehave. I'll count for you the ways I've been betrayed.
Alright, I still gotta adjust the levels here. We're gonna be right back. No, we won't. We already listened to that, but hey. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna play it for you. The Marky Ramone School of Mumbling. Let me know if you guys want to enroll in the Marky Ramone School of Mumbling, okay?
Hi, I'm Marky Ramone. Have you ever dreamed of making it to the top of the charts as a recording artist? Do people tell you that you have a lovely singing voice? Can people understand clearly every word you say? Then have no fear, you don't have to sound like Michael Bolton any longer. Sign up now at the Marky Ramone School of Mumbling. In just 2 short weeks, we'll take you from this.
I can see clearly now, the rain has
gone. Alright, try it.
No, I understood every word you said.
To this.
Amaze your friends with this new talent, and just think, you can swear as much as you want on your albums without getting a warning sticker, because no one on the censor board will understand a word you're saying. Sign up now at the Marky Ramone School of Mumbling, and you'll get all the studying materials, lessons for this educational 2-week course for the low, low price of just... Yes, that's right, only... Sign up now!
Alrighty, hey guys, play something real quick. Okay.
Okay for you.
Alright, stop. Alright, now, Dan, go ahead.
Sit down, children, don't misbehave. I'll count for you the ways I've been betrayed.
How's that? Guys, go hit something.
Don't misbehave. I'll count for you the ways I've been betrayed. Said it before, no need to speak. You're a waste of breath, only that makes you weak.
Unplugged almost. It's.
When you yell, pull it away.
No, we yell when
I. You know what I'm gonna do?
When you do. Another song. I got a job making money for the man. Throw a chicken in a bucket with a soda pop can. Cute green uniform on my back. I had to set it on fire in Nevada chicken fat. I leaped on the counter like a bird with no hair. Running through the many mall in my underwear. I got lost downtown, couldn't find a ride home. Sun went down, I got frozen to the bone. Till a hooker let me share her fake fur coat. As I took a little nap, the cops picked up the spoon. I tried to explain, I was only trying to get warm. I knew I never ever should have burned my uniform. He said, too bad, but I'm like the bullet hard son.
Endeavors. But we strongly encourage unique and creative innovations in the student broadcast community. Thank you for supporting your local college radio station.
The station you are listening to is a member of the National Association of College Broadcasters. As a member of this nonprofit corporation, it is our goal to provide an exchange of ideas, programming, and information in the student media community and among students, faculty, and professionals. It is also our goal to both facilitate growth, prestige, and recognition of the student media community, as well as to protect and lobby for the laws and regulations that affect this vital community. It is this station's mission to encourage and assist fellow stations and individuals in attaining high standards which will enhance the community served by those involved in college broadcasting. We hope to provide opportunities for individuals with an interest in media and communications. Not only do we support student media endeavors, but strongly encourage unique and creative innovations in the student broadcast community.
Okay, here we go. This is Bloodshot live here at WECS, something different. And take it away, guys, anytime now.
Is this mixed?
Sound children, don't misbehave. I count for you the ways I've been betrayed. I've said it before, no need to speak. Your waste of breath only makes you weak. Yeah. Don't repeat what I've said. I'll read it thought ahead. Breaking every word of God, I'm a widow what you know. I'll lead the way, don't run ahead. I know the story, this is love is dead. Life's to follow and not to seek. Naive impulse, it shows that you're weak. Yeah! Don't repeat what I say. I'm already thought ahead. Breaking in the word of God. Follow you.
I finally got hooked up. I don't know, one of the wires was loose or something, but it sounded great after. In the beginning, it sounded like it was acoustic because I couldn't hear those guys. I could only hear you, but hey. Anyway, we'll do this again. We'll do another one. Just it's hard to calibrate your voice with them.
Oh well.
Oh well, it still sounded good, but what do you want to do next?
I think we'll do a song called Downbeat.
That's the new one, right?
Yep, that's a new bluesy type song. And the drummer will be playing guitar.
Ah!
The drummer is Jordan Nyer. I am Dan Smolin, the lead singer.
Get this guy doing some work here. Get this drummer. Just because he forgot his drums.
He didn't forget him. We couldn't bring him.
Oh.
It wasn't his fault. I'm going to have to see him through the window so I could point to him to when we change parts.
Cues. You can't hear yourself in the headphones?
No, I heard myself, but I couldn't hear them, so I figured I may as well leave it off. That way I could just hear.
I think you can hear him now. Try it. You should be able to. This one. Hit something.
In a town where the cops beat you down, I was born a life of crime. With my feet chained together, nowhere, never got no better, and I'm tired of doing time. I was born in a paradise. I was born with nothing to lose. I was born in a paradise. I was born with nothing to lose. Grab my old 44 to the convenience store and said, give me all of your dough. The kid, he just ducked, and the cops all showed up, and they all beat me down to the floor. Born in a pair of boots, I was born with nothing to lose. I was born in a pair of boots, I was born with nothing to lose. Rolling real sick, so I stopped in the clinic, and the doctor didn't do what he should. Said, pull your pants off. So I blew his head off, and I put him out of practice for good. Feeling better than hell, I thought I may as well stop in at the local bar. I walked into the door and was beaten to the floor. No, they didn't let me get very far. That was a surprise. I was born in a bed of boots. I was born with nothing to lose. Yeah, I was born in a bed of boots. I was born with nothing to lose. That was Downbeat.
I like that. That was a very original. Can I hear myself? Oh my gosh. There we go. Okay. Woo! You guys are coordinated there.
We're versatile.
Was that a surprise or something in there?
He switched the distortion when I didn't think he would.
Aha. I didn't think he would either. I was very surprised. You're fired. Get back to the drums now.
Yes.
All right, what do you got next for us?
All right, next we're going to do a song called Angela Song. And I don't know if she's listening or not because I couldn't get through to her, so it's not my fault if she doesn't hear it. So I think Dave should start it right now.
Angela Song.
so bright. I dissolve into something lighter, diffusing into the night. In panic burning brighter, I can still stand the night because she said I'd be alright. And it was, and it was, and it, the snakes are in the chest tonight. Anxious little locksmiths, the clouds rolling through my head are making harder to predict. She held me tight. Yeah, she said I'll be alright. And it was, and it was, and it was. That was Angela's song.
Angela, I hope that was you who called. Somebody called during that song. I don't know who it was, but we'll find out later. Tell you what, if you got any questions for Bloodshot, give us a call at 456-2164. We'll ask them. Maybe you thought of something I didn't. Who knows?
Give a shout out to the Windsor Posse. At least those were cool.
Hey, I'm gonna put you on the air. Ooh, my gosh. Hello, ECS, you're on the air. Very intelligent caller.
What was that?
I don't know.
What'd they say?
He goes, wiki, wiki, wiki. I think he was one of those rap artists or something. He was a rap fan.
I want to answer that.
Answer it.
Yes.
Yes? Oh, I would have said no, but hey. we did that. Okay. Tell you what, we're going to play one song from Beck. And then we're going to be back with Bloodshot right here. Something different. WECS. Whoops. We were going to play that. Thank you. Play. Play. I have the power to play. Thank you. The Village. The Village right here at WECS. They're a local group that we had down here in the past. You like that?
Yeah, yep.
You like? That's pretty good. I've seen them play a couple times live. They're really good live. Excellent live. But hey, so aren't you. And we're going to play another song from you.
Okay, good. It's a cover of a Nirvana song you're probably all familiar with. It's called Polly.
Polly wants a cracker. Oh, you guys are ready now? Okay, I was going to do the tape first, but it doesn't matter. We'll do Polly.
You guys ready?
You guys ready?
Ready.
Polly wants a cracker. Think I should get off her first. She wants some water to put out the blowtorch. Yes, me has some seed. Let me clip dinner wings. Let me take a ride. Hurt yourself. Want some help? Please myself. Got some rope, haven't told. Promise you, have been true. Polly wants some back. Maybe she would like some food.
I've forgotten the words.
Isn't me, haven't said. Let me clap. Dirty wings, let me take a ride. Hurt yourself. Want some help? Please myself. Got some rope, haven't told. Promise you, haven't told. Let me take a ride. Hurt yourself. Want some blood? Please myself. Polly said, Your body says her back hurts. She's just as bored as me. She cut me off my guard. Mazes me the wheel of instinct. Listen to me, you have some seed. When you clap, 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 dirty wings, wings, wings. When you take a ride, cut yourself. Want some help, please myself. You got some help, I've been told. I promise you, have been told. When you take a ride, cut yourself. Want some help, please myself. Kick that.
I didn't know they had a solo in Poly. All right.
It's extra.
Extra for bonus the cost track of nothing.
Bonus.
All right, we've got a call. If you want to, we're going to put you on the air. You can ask them a question. All right, we're going to put you on the air. ECS, you're on the air.
Hi, Dan.
Hi.
Hi.
Can you hear me?
Hello. Who is this?
What?
This is Nilly Nil.
Who is this?
Hello.
Go ahead, Nil.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey, Dan. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Oh, pretty good.
Where are you?
I'm at home.
Oh, you're at home. I thought you'd be at the record store.
It's closed.
Where are you?
No, I'm on the radio.
You guys sound really good.
Thanks.
It's kind of hard to play in this little studio, but otherwise.
God, they sound great.
Yeah.
How did you guys figure out all the lyrics to that song?
Because the Lithium single.
Okay.
I was almost ready to whip it out for you in case you forgot the words.
Are the words in the Nevermind?
No.
No.
Oh, okay. I didn't think so.
You guys know what that song is about?
No.
I didn't think so.
About a bird?
No, not quite.
Oh, you have Einstein in there, too.
No, it's a very complicated song, complicated subject.
Well, what's it about?
It's about a rape.
Oh.
Ooh, now it's very serious for you. It loses all of its meaning for you.
No, no. Well, opens the doors.
So do you have any questions there, Nilly Nil?
Oh, gosh, I don't know. Well, what bands, and this is going to sound stupid because it's not really an original question, but what bands influence you? I mean, I know the stuff that you buy because I sell it to you, but I mean, like the sugar cubes, you know.
Sugar cubes?
Yes. Like the sugar cubes.
Oh my gosh.
I'm influenced by Johnny Rotten, Bjork, and...
Oh, God.
Let's see.
How about Trent Reznor?
A little bit, but he's too artistic.
Artistic?
Artistic.
I was influenced by Dvorak.
Also, Weird Al Yankovic, and and Billy Idol.
Yeah.
My influences are like Mozart and Bach, so we kind of call it a mock piece, if you will.
I can tell.
I just listen to Cyndi Lauper. Cyndi Lauper is really cool.
Yeah.
Girls just want to
I like Cyndi Lauper. She's my idol.
Oh, God. Mine, too.
Yeah.
No, she's happy-go-lucky. I like that.
I like her hair.
I don't know what it looks like nowadays.
It's bleach blonde now, I think.
I liked it when it was red and scraggly.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was cool. I remember that video with the wrestler guy.
Yeah,
Luke. Yeah.
That was funny.
Oh, Nilly Nil.
Anyway, so this you guys cool. Gonna play more songs?
I don't think so. We don't know.
We don't
anymore.
Know anymore.
And plus, the drums are gone.
Oh, the drums are gone. Why don't you get a drum machine?
We'll play some off of our demo for you if you want.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you guys have a hate song?
A hate song?
Loser Elite.
Yeah, Luther Elite's a hate song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can play it for one of your Windsor buddies who I can't stand.
Who?
Well, his initials are JB.
And why don't you like him?
You know why, Mark. He was here last night.
Where?
Here.
Oh, you know?
Who?
You know him?
I don't know.
They probably do. That's a small town.
We'll talk off the air. This loser
I can't
elite.
Stand him. He's
this
a
is
loser.
Definitely going out to him.
All right, cool.
Wake
okay.
Forest.
Hey, keep up the good work.
Yep, thanks.
All right, thanks, Nilly.
I'll see you soon.
Yep, I will.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Nilly Nil calling up. Thank you very much. And if you have any questions for the group, Bloodshot, give us a call here at 456-2164. I wonder if Jay's listening. I told Jay, to, Jay Forklift, we call him. Used to be in the band Forklift or something like that.
He's an MI6 now.
MI6.
He's cool.
Is he? I've never heard the group, but I've
well,
heard
he's
of
cool.
Him. He's okay. He ranks on me a lot, so I you think I don't know that, Jay, but I have sources. I have hidden microphones in Store 24.
In your face.
All right. Now we've got to cue this up somehow. So what we're going to do is we're going to play the Fabulous Five song number 3. Fabulous Five song
number 3.
And it's from Mudhoney right here. Why don't I put it into the CD player? Then we can play it. Sounds like a smashing idea. It's the latest from Mudhoney. It's called Pump It Up, a very good cover of Elvis Costello's song. Wait, do we have a caller on the line? I'm going to put you on the
air. Hello, ECS here on the air.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
This is Keith from Windsor.
Hey, Keith, how you doing?
All right.
We're not talking about you. You're not, right. You're not the loser elite, at least not that we know of. But anyway, what can we do for you?
Can I talk to Matt?
You can talk to Matt or anybody you want.
Hello?
Are you, Matt, well, you're the up? One that you got... He's not the one you guys ranked on, are you?
No.
Okay, that was well, KC.
Yeah.
Hello?
Okay.
Matt?
Yeah.
What's up?
Nothing much, Keith.
This isn't like a call to just say hi, is it?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
You got questions for us, Matt?
Yeah, when are you guys playing?
Right now.
I mean, next gig.
Gig? Well, we're probably going to be playing at the Sports Palace sometime this summer.
Ah.
We haven't gotten any definite dates yet, but we've got a lot of promises. Hopefully they'll come through.
And that's as cool. soon as you find out, you have to let me know, and I'll let everybody else know.
We'll give you a call the night we find out.
Who's talking?
Hello?
Oh, you are. I was like, I'm looking around, and I don't see any lips moving. Anyhow. Yeah, Sports Palace, that's a pretty big place. That's in what, New Britain?
Yeah.
Yep. That's cool. Our drummer's brothers set up shows there for people before.
Oh.
So we might be able to get in there.
Our manager.
Any plans well, for the got, Hartford Soup Center?
He's like Reuben Kincaid.
He's got hookups, let's say.
Reuben Kincaid of the Casey... No, what was it?
Partridge Family.
Partridge Family, I was thinking sitcom, 70s. Anyhow, any other questions there for Matt?
Yeah, Matt. So are we coming over tomorrow?
Yeah, you're coming over tomorrow. All
right.
Thanks. Thanks
a lot. Is that appropriate for the air? That was air inappropriate
hey,
on him.
Hey, can I borrow your sneakers tomorrow? Thanks for calling. All right, bye-bye.
Bombed.
Oh, if you have any questions...
real questions.
Legitimate questions.
...that pertain to their music, and not just want to say, hey, are you coming over tomorrow?
Yeah, don't come on the air and pull our you-know-whats.
But you can, like, ask us sexual questions.
So about those Get Wet girls.
Oh, yeah.
They, the Get Wet... One of the Get Wet girls, we believe, appears on our tape. On.
Did you get permission to use that?
Well, it was a prank call, so I mean, hey.
Hey,
you know,
left it on your machine.
Exactly. Your machine, they gave it to me.
They gave it to you,
basically. Well, in so many words.
Well played for you, so you know what we're talking about. It's pretty cool. It's kind of dubbed into the song. It's like all of a sudden you hear, if you'd like a free whipped cream demonstration. Oh, boy. What happened? Oh, my headphones are going out. Anyways, I thought that was professionally done, or maybe it was like a friend of yours, but no.
No.
It was the actual Get Wet Girls.
And this was before the Get Wet Girls got famous, right?
Yep. Yeah. That's so it's.
We gave them their start.
Yeah, we got them off.
Well, they're not going to say the opposite. They're going to say that they gave you fame, and they're going to want royalty money, but hey.
Well, we got them in trouble for prank calls. Right?
Yeah, I know.
Give us some free stuff. Yeah, how about that whipped cream?
So you're the ones that they were talking about in that newspaper article. One of the guys they visited.
No.
How did they get to call you?
Because it was like a wrong number. We cut the part out where it said Get Wet Girls, and we cut because we had to cut the name out because they were asking for some guy named Michael Barillo or something. And so if Michael Barillo is out there, you missed your chance.
Oh, you missed the Get Wet Girls. I bet he works for the Daily Campus.
Probably.
Actually, I think he probably was belonging to Teak or something like that. One of those fraternities, because they're all scum.
Actually, he's a professor. He wanted to do with the class there. Anyways. Oh, boy. We got it for you. We're going to play this song by, oh, yeah, Mudhoney. And then we're going to set up the cassette and we'll do something from the demo.
Hi, sweetie. What you doing?
Daddy.
Shh. Why is it so dark in here?
Okay, that was our public service announcement for this hour. Anyways, we're going to do the acoustic toy convent.
Well, not really acoustic. It's not acoustic.
Well, it's not acoustic, but it's like...
Drumless.
Drumless. Because we have no drum machine.
Well, the drummer's here.
Say hi, drummer.
What up?
Just kind of like beat your pants or something. There you go. That's all we need. The song you just heard, Toy Convict, done live. Any time.
Hello.
You guys ready? Hit it! No.
Let me off off your back. Never mind if you're a jack. Did you win a silver spoon? Couldn't miss a smile for you. Yeah, I'm alone, you. Yeah, I come and hold me. Yeah, I control me. Yeah, to a convict. Push it in, squeeze it dry. Not the mud, but we deny. What tables till they gleam? What's constituted clean? Yeah, I'm lonely! Yeah! Come and hold me! Yeah! Control me! Yeah! Toy convict!
That was awesome.
Your nice putting the floor, that's fucking cockles and social law. Hoping Darwin's keeping up track, but they all seem to grow right back. Yeah, I'm lonely! Yeah, come and hold me! Yeah, I control me! Yeah, to a convict! I'm lonely! Yeah, come and hold me! Yeah, I control me! Yeah, Toy Convict!
Woo! Yeah, sorry, Bobby boy. That was Toy Convict.
Hello, Angela.
Hello, Angela. Say hello again real quick, everybody, while we got it on tape.
Hello, Angela. Hello, Mom and Dad.
So the Windsor Posse and Tempted Evil and everybody.
I'd like to apologize for messing up that song, because it is cool.
You messed it up. It was all your fault.
No.
What's with you, man?
I'm going to blow my own head off and write a note about it.
And then we can all read about it, and your girlfriend can call you an mm-mm. Anyhow.
Hello, Michelle, I love you.
Michelle, my bell.
Bridget.
And Neil. And if you have any questions right now, 456-2164, otherwise,
call me.
We will bid them adieu. If you, the Get Wet girls want to call here, and we'll leave a message. Hey, go ahead. Anyhow, thank you guys for coming down tonight. Bloodshot for you, ladies and gentlemen. We had a great time.
Thank you very much.
I was surprised. But despite all the
technical errors.
Technical difficulties here, we had a great time. All right. Say goodbye. And
goodbye.
Take it easy.
We love you.
Peace out for listening.
Okay, we'll be back with more music after this and something different. WECS we have for you. A bunch off the Flintstones soundtrack. Enjoy.